space and time. Wide awake, out of paper signs.
Wale, Wale,
I am out my mind. Outer space.
There's only one nigga. One nigga.
To a place where nobody knows. Floating at a pace where now you see me.
Look, look. I spit bars, you can't escape like Alcatraz. I'm working hard while these other niggas gallivant. Shocking the world like.
¿Qué hay, listeros? Bienvenidos a Casa Deportes y bienvenidos al episodio número 6 con el NBA 2K16 con Kareem Jackson. Y no tengo palabras para lo que acaban de ver en el inicio. Es de las cosas que nos tiene preparado el 2K16. Es de las cosas que hacen este juego fenomenal, que estoy muy contento con esta serie, con el recibimiento que ha tenido. Y muy contento con este partido que es contra Anthony Davis, The Brow. Y vemos que no hay mucha gente en el estadio, por lo mismo que el Utah Jazz no es considerado los mejores equipos dentro de la NBA, que todavía está en reconstrucción. Pero cuando tienes a Kareem Jackson poniéndole alley-oops a Gordon Hayward, la esperanza al final del túnel se empieza a hacer cada vez más grande y Utah puede soñar en volver a ser el equipo que no fue, que fue hace poco tiempo. En realidad, este partido no tuvo mucho más porque, repito, estoy recibiendo pocos minutos, pero creo que le voy a encontrar una solución a eso, y es que aumento los minutos. Vi que tenía los minutos 6 minutos por cuarto, dije, vamos poniendo 8 minutos por cuarto a ver si así puedo jugar algo más. Y ahora vamos a recibir a James Harden, la barba, y vamos a intentar hacer un mejor partido poniendo asistencias. Kareem Jackson ya está demostrando lo que puede hacer con las asistencias. Ahí vemos a la mascota toda contenta. Y ahora el balón en manos de Carlos King enfrentando a Patrick Beverly. Pedimos el bloqueo de Trey Lyles y eso libera a Hood ahí afuera. Pide la mesa para tres. ¡Sí, señor! Ese balón está dentro del aro de las redes. Está siendo ahora movido por Patrick Beverly. No sé por qué no está Ty Lawson. Kareem Jackson poniendo la presión defensiva sobre Patrick Beverly. No pierdan de vista James Harden la barba, que obviamente es uno de los grandes rivales que vamos a tener en esta serie. James Harden enfrentando a Dante Exum, pero Kareem Jackson llega a apoyar y mejor tiene el rebote defensivo. Muy bien Kareem Jackson, de costa a costa, de este a oeste. Le damos el balón a Trevor Booker y él consigue los dos puntos, la asistencia para Kareem Jackson en estas dos series ofensivas que nos ha ido bastante bien. Ahora Patrick Beverly conduce el balón y James Harden, adiós.
Like I'm Goodwill hunting. Take a tour peek before I even reach the summit. But busting a plummet. She never saw me coming, nigga. I ain't even fronting. Slam onto the pussy like Andre Drummond. All starters on my team. We don't need Kirk Cousins. Ay, heavy flows, getting hard to stomach. Money on my mind.
¡Qué buen bloqueo de Kareem Jackson! Y ahora le damos el balón a Dante Exum, que no se animó a tirar y darle la asistencia a Kareem. Kareem Jackson intenta liberarse, pide el balón debajo del aro, consigue los dos puntos. ¡Ay! Por poco y no los consigue, pero freaking and vibing, bailando Kareem. Y ahora enfrentamos a Patrick Beverly, dame eso. Mujeres y niños, primero toma el primer mate en la NBA para Kareem Jackson. Galardón desbloqueado. El mejor partido en la NBA hasta ahora para Kareem Jackson, que no se lo puede creer, hasta se tarda en reaccionar de felicidad. Obviamente, muchas de las miradas del público ahora voltean a Kareem Jackson e inclusive su agente les consigue esto a Kareem.
Don Pagnotti always delivers. Brand Jordan freak prototypes. Open the box, check them out.
Like Christmas and my birthday on the same day. Oh. Oh, Don.
You love them?
I love them.
Hey, ooh. They're waiting for your approval for production.
Approved.
Approved?
Approved.
Done. I'll make the call.
In Pagnotti, we trust.
I told you you'd love them.
Man.
Hey, I'm going to have you playing in those in 30 days or less.
Oh, money. Oh man.
Freaking and vibing. Freaking and vibing.
Freaking and vibing in these, baby.
Una de las animaciones que habíamos visto en el NBA pasado y en este canal es el himno nacional de los Estados Unidos. Y aquí está el Utah Jazz ahora regresando a la casa de Kareem Jackson. Harlem, Nueva York, sí está ahí. Vic Von Leer, la familia de Kareem. Frequency Vibrations, iba a decir Freaking and Vibing, pero eso es como lo que lo hace ser Frequency Vibrations. Así que será un partido importante para Freak. Querrá tomar las riendas, querrá demostrar todo su talento. Va a tener más minutos, seguramente. solamente porque ya aumenté los minutos. Y me refiero a los minutos del partido. No, no te puedes aumentar tú los minutos que te da el entrenador. Aquí le ponemos el pase sensacional a nuestro compañero, a nuestro, pues vamos a decirle compañero de pick, ¿no? A Trey Lyles, porque literalmente llegamos en el mismo pick que él. Él tiene mucho futuro en la NBA y parece que va a ser un excelente jugador. Y ahora con los pasos de baile, Kareem Jackson intentando librarse la marca de José Calderón, yendo de un lado a otro. Kareem Jackson intenta penetrar la pintura, lo consigue. And one, tiro adicional por Kareem Jackson. No flex zone, no flex zone, estirando Kareem Jackson. Aquí queda libre para Mesa para tres. Sí señor, sí señor, no. Y es el rebote para Kelly O'Quinn. Y ahora el balón es de los Knicks, pero Kareem Jackson en la persecución. Kareem Jackson. I rap that sick world, get affiliated. And you pussy rappers need stimulated. And you're not dope, you've been manipulated. And you're not sick, you're a healthy patient. Got brass knuckles to stuff anyone that's hating. And you haven't hustled, you just take vacations. You don't know the struggle of days in the basement. You sit on your ass until your life is wasted. You lack the drive and then you lack the patience. Please step aside from my worldwide invasion. I get dizzy high and strike from the spaceship. I crash and dive and go super saiyan like legitimately sickening every time when I rap on the track. I have an epiphany. Bienvenido al salón de los bloqueos de Kareem Jackson, donde ya está James Harden. Y ahora también se une Aaron Aflalo. Aquí le damos el balón a Trevor Booker en el poste bajo. Se intenta mover Kareem Jackson, liberarse. Y pide el tiro desde el codo. Sí señor, bien conseguido. Kareem Jackson no se lo puede creer. Derek Fisher está estupefacto de lo que está haciendo Kareem Jackson esta noche en su casa. Esto es prácticamente la casa, el Madison Square Garden de Kareem Jackson. ¿Será que alguna vez jugará ahí con los Knicks? Es una posibilidad. Aquí vean con el... Oh. ¡Qué fenomenal! El bloqueo nos libera todo el callejón para que avancemos y consigamos el finger roll sencillo. Ahora nos dan todo el espacio para que hagamos esto, Kareem Jackson. Así, demostrando todo su poder, toda su verticalidad, elevándose. Y, ¿para qué brincabas, viejo? Ya era simplemente los dos puntos de trámite para Kareem, que ahora está defendiendo a Carmelo Anthony. Carmelo Anthony no puede con la defensa de Kareem Jackson, quien consigue el rebote defensivo. Y nos vamos de costa a costa, de este a oeste. Ahora quedo solo. ¡Vamos, Kareem, tira! ¡Sí, señor! Trabajando el tiro desde media distancia. Y le dice al Madison Square Garden que no los puede escuchar. Y Carmelo Anthony, que sacaba los pasos de baile, pero no pudo con la defensiva de Kareem Jackson. ¡Que mujeres y niños primero! Y no pueden abandonar el avión porque Kareem Jackson estuvo on fire todo este partido. Así lo celebra. 110 a 77 le pusimos una paliza a los Knicks de Nueva York. Y con estadísticas como estas, leales youtuberos, Kareem Jackson seguramente llamó la atención de sus compañeros y sobre todo de su entrenador, de la afición. Vamos a esta animación de la película de Kareem.
As I was saying, got a real big problem, all this kitty stuff. Your evil twin CeCe and Dom got you doing a vet. What was that word he was using?
Rebrand?
No. Recalibrate. All this stuff they got you doing to recalibrate your image has cost you in the hood, fam. Yo, the streets is watching, and they're not convinced.
Vic, how many times do I have to tell you? The streets ain't always right, man.
Nah. It's always good in the hood. Let's not forget, I am a student of human nature, all right? Take your man here. He's playing this here video game is to not address the reason why his brand Jordan sneakers are sitting on store shelves collecting dust.
Ooh.
Ouch. Okay, what are your suggestions, Victor?
He wants you to rob a bodega. I'm sorry.
Look, man, I'm not talking about some focus group, all right? I'm talking about the hood. They don't trust you no more. They see you coming to the arenas wearing them tight pants y'all ballers be wearing. Your high water ankles be showing. Your pants is just so tight, man. Your ankles be choking. Air it out some. People don't see themselves in you anymore. Look at me. People don't recognize themselves in who you are. Okay, you want to recalibrate? Fine, B, go ahead. Recalibrate back to Harlem. Remind these fools where you from. Represent, you know what I'm saying? Like, where's that Jesus piece you used to rock? Not that Shuttlesworth.
With them fake chains we used to wear.
Yo, but that's my point. Yo, let me get you some nice jewels, huh? Make it flossy. Get you a new whip, something that the hood would love. Let's remind these fools that you the Harlem Renaissance up in this piece. Get a club, I don't know, something. Just throw your weight around, man.
I mean, at least get me some, too.
Yeah, and get some nice free bet, too.
Nah, but for real, in all seriousness, you think it's that bad?
Yo.
Cats be laughing at your corny commercials, B.
Come on.
But that's what I'm saying. Yo, we could change all that. Hey, now, I know CC's your manager and all, but everywhere she leads, you can't always follow. Now, I'm not trying to catch no charge, but CC got people out here laughing at you, fam. Now, just let me take care of everything. You the CEO, I'm the CFO, chief flossing officer. You hit me with that bread, and I got you.
CC.
How y'all doing?
What up, CC?
Freak, can I talk to you for a second?
Yeah, what up?
In private?
CC, go ahead.
Okay, well, I thought we were supposed to be having a private meeting today to discuss business.
CC, what you think we're doing?
Am I talking to you? You know what? Y'all ain't talking business. Y'all talking nonsense.
We were actually discussing the questionable nature of the promotional strategy that you and Dom have employed on Freak's behalf. Now, it doesn't necessarily resonate with his core fan base, primarily due to the fact that it negates the legitimacy of his personal background and history in favor of reaching a larger, primarily more disinterested demographic that would prefer to judge Freak's past as opposed to appreciate it.
Yo, what Yvette said, 4 × 25, 100.
Oh, so now you know your times tables. Yvette, occasionally proving that you're articulate doesn't mean you have business acumen. Beyond, of course, your clear mastery of basic arithmetic. We all know you can add up how much Freak makes.
Okay, CC, that's enough.
No, you know what, CC? You're absolutely
Anywho,
right.
Freak,
and speaking of basic arithmetic, how much of Freak's money do you take?
Okay, I mean, what did I just say about
Team Freak? A manager?
What did I just say about Team Freak?
The only members of Team Freak in here are me and you.
Oh, you know what, CC? This isn't the womb, okay? It's not just you and Freak.
Speaking of, how's that going for you?
Hey, come on.
Oh, snap!
You gonna let her talk to me like that, really?
You need to check her out. Yo, I ain't even talking about her.
Yeah.
Yo, I'm out.
You know what? I think I'll join you.
No, darlings, please. Please, have a seat. I would just love to hear what you all were just discussing. Better yet, let me guess. Hey, yo, I'm saying, dude, what you need to do is hit up these parties. Yeah, you need to show these fools how you still have mad love for the hood. Get you some flossy jewels. Make sure every time they see you, it's in the new whip. Better yet, let's get us a dealership or a club or something. Never mind that house you promised your twin sister, you promised you'd get for your parents who are still in the projects where you left them.
Yo, that's not fair. I ain't leaving my ass.
Hey,
and you know I'll never leave my parents in projects.
Thing, fam. I'll take care of everything. All you gotta do is break me off with that bread. Yeah, that's what I thought.
Wow. You know what, CC? I don't know what's going on with you tonight, but I think it's best you go home. We will continue our meeting here.
You asking me to leave?
Yes.
Hey, yo, Freak. It's all good, man. As a matter of fact, CC, I know you don't like me. You never have. Now, I don't know what I ever did to you. But at this point, does it really matter anymore? Look, I just want you to know that I'm really sorry. But whatever it was, I can honestly say it was not intentional. All right? Hey, Freak, think about what I said earlier, man. I ain't trying to catch no charge. Vet, you ready?
Let's bounce.
CC. Okay, you know I love you more than life itself.
And how come you always put them before me? I don't put anyone above you, not even myself.
You sure about that, CC? What would you just call all this? I mean, you come in here blowing up my spot and you insult my brother?
He's not our brother.
You disrespect my woman.
Just trying to protect you.
From who? From the likes of you? But you don't think I realize that I have vultures and blood-sucking leeches in my life? Don't think I realize that you're one of them?
Bloodsucker?
Yeah, but you know what? That's what I think the problem is. Because you realize you're no better than them and you're ashamed. But in fact, you're worse because we share the same blood.
And just because they don't have the same blood running through their veins as us, doesn't mean that they don't love me. Yeah, their love might be flawed, but it's true. What you need to understand is I don't need you to protect me anymore. I don't mind the people closest to me leeching off me. Yes, you do leech off me, and I leech off you too. You love business and you love me. I use that. Vic? You know you don't mind running these streets. He's my connection to things I don't want to deal with anymore, so I let him do him. I take care of him, and in return, he looks out for me in places you know you can't. And as much as you don't want to hear this, Yvette, she is the eye of the storm in my life right now. She is my only calm. She's my peace, my shelter. I use these people and they use me. I just don't call it that, CeCe. I don't call what you do using me, I call what you do caring for me. Forgive yourself and forgive them for using the resources at their disposal to get what they need. And what you need to learn to do is just trust me. Okay, I've always had a good judge of character, even before I was born. Remember? Because I chose to come in this world with you. That's right. It was me and you in the womb just kicking it. Right?
I was born first.
Yeah, you were. Swish.
Some people say you just hang around, that you're a leech. Why is that the word?
Because people just don't know.
They be hating.
They hating on my game. They hating on our friendship. See, FOF, friend of freak. See, nobody got that like I do. And everybody else wants that. Who doesn't? But that's my boy. I'm in that spot. That is my lane. And everybody else just got to make way for that, you know?
That's him, but who are you?
Nah, man, I got my own life, you know? People think I'm just sitting back and riding on him, but that's not the case, yo. I got dreams. I got dreams, yo. See, my boy knows, right? There's two ways that I could do this. I could do it a legit way, or I could do it the crooked way. And I'm really, really, really trying not to do it the crooked way, but Freak can't help me do that.
He could put you on?
Maybe. You got to do what you got to do when you need to do it to get ahead.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what I do, and I'm just really good at it. What can I say? I get by, day by day, step by step.
Geniales, youtuberos, eso fue Toño por este video. Muchas gracias, ya saben qué hacer. Si les gustó, los likes siempre son bien recibidos y los comentarios intentan ser contestados. No olviden seguirme en mis redes sociales, en Twitter y en Facebook, para estar enterado de toda la actividad del canal y poder contactarme de forma más directa. No olviden comer frutas y verduras. Muchas gracias por todo el apoyo a esta y todas las demás series en Case Deportes. Recuerden que los calendarios de subida están en la descripción del video y siempre es importante leer la descripción del video porque puede haber sorpresas o simplemente para datos que les puedan quedar, no les queden claros. Y leales youtuberos, les digo, también ahí pongo noticias a veces importantes en la descripción del video que luego están preguntando en la sección de comentarios y siempre es importante leerla y obviamente por esta clase de menú que les pongo de la película de Kareem Jackson. Como ya decía, no olviden comer frutas y verduras y que ¡ay, nos solemos!